Yes, good evening everybody. My name is Nitin Naik. Today I am giving the presentation on emergency management in golden hours. Okay, this is slightly a medical related topic. As per the today's scenario, this is very much important because everybody has to know this, at least the basic. But before starting through the presentation, I just want to interact with you people. So your name? By profession? Business. Yes? Okay. What, you're a student or working service business? Psychologist. Okay. You're? Yeah. Baith ke bolo, no problem. Service, okay. Okay. Engineer. Business. Okay. Student. Okay. Student. Okay, so all the categories, student, business, service, doctor, from railway. Okay. I just want to ask one question to you people. If there is an emergency, what is your first action? Okay, then? Yes, sir? First aid is the action. Okay, why? Okay. Understood. Okay. Wrong point. But I add the supplementary to this is, it depends upon the situation, ki what is needed on that emergency. Is really needed the first aid or is really needed the something else also? No, we can't predict that ki what we needed it. So, what is emergency management? And another question is, what do you mean golden hours? First question is, what is emergency management? Okay. First hour. Is it 1 hour? Or first?
Seconds could be important.
Yeah, even seconds could be important. Yes, sir? Yeah, tell me. No. Thoda. Yes. Okay. Yeah, that's the life-saving time period is the golden hours. It's depend upon the injury, it's depend upon the casualty, it's depend upon the situation. Because, for example, if you take the heart attack, the 20 minutes is important. If we take to the blooding, it's 30 minutes is important. Or depend upon the person height and weight and the age. Okay, how much the body total blood is in his body. So depend if starting point of the incident up to the handling of doctor, okay, what's the duration of that? First, minus what's the incident or the accident or the casualty need time. That casualty need time is the golden hour. Casualty need time in the sense to cure his wounds, to cure his whatever the fracture, to cure his whatever the infections, whatever the injury he has. So we are today looking here, okay, what is the emergency management and what is the golden hour, and how can its benefit to the injured person or the casualty. Okay? So if suppose we take the central railway is here. The latest back example of railway bomb blast. Okay, and other examples are there. And we always read these examples in newspaper, media, as well as electronic media. So what is the emergency? First we take the tsunami. See, when the tsunami comes, that time all the people running here and there, and all the waves is much more heightened than the human, and it takes. Then earthquake. See, when the earthquake happens, what the emergency comes. Building gets collapsed. Accidents. See, this is the one accident in Thane. TMT has been collapsed. Bomb blast. This is railway. Mumbai blast. If you see the casualties lying here and there, everywhere, injured. See, one of the casualties just lying, few people are helping. This is Maligao bomb blast. Then fire accidents. This is few Mumbai fire brigade attended calls. This is the n number of people rescued alive in fire and other calls in Mumbai since 1990 to 2007. These all are the yearly report. Means you can imagine that how many people get injured every year in fire call. Not only the persons, even the animal also get injured in fire. We always think about the human life, but there is animal lives also. Then fire in high-rise buildings. If suppose fire in the high-rise building, because in the city like Mumbai, if you see the Tardev area, there is a 60-storage building. One is Lodha complex is coming, which is 100 plus. Okay, and if Kulaba area and other area, the 15 storage, 20, 30, 35, 40. 40 is the currently normal. 35, 40 is in Mumbai is the normal. So this is the currently scenario. Okay. Now my question is, if any of this building on the fourth floor there is a fire, okay, all staircase is blocked, everything is blocked. So take the example of 30 storage building. So how the top floor, 30, means 6th floor to 30th floor, the n number of people, how the rescue, what is the rescue method? Mumbai fire brigade ladder, if you have the answer of that, then Mumbai fire brigade ladder is up to the 21st floor or maximum 30. But one, if suppose one ladder came, that call is a snorkel. Okay? See the congested road. They are not satisfied to enter the ladder, that whole bus or whole that trailer, ladder trailer. Because the size is 20 feet big, it can't easily take the turns also. Okay? But God is great, one ladder has been came. Now we are calculating few figures from 6th floor to 30th floor, because we are taking the example of 30th floor. How many? Every floor has a 4 flats. Okay? So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and other 20 and this 5, 15 floors. 15 into 4 flats. How many flats are there? 60 flats. Okay, 60 flat. Each flat has the 4 people. How many people? 60 into 4. 240 people, and ladder is 1. So how many we can rescue at a time, within a time management? Understood? And everybody want to take the exit, so everybody want to use that ladder, so stampede chances are there, injury chances are there, because everybody in a hurry, are ladder khada hai, chalo jaldi chalo. So staircase, they are coming with the help of staircase up to the floor where the ladder is reached. So, kahin na kahin unko chot aayegi. There is something happen. So, what's the solution? Then building gets collapsed where the people get injured. See the collapse building in the every year. since 2007. All the figures are in 3-digit, not in a 2-digit or 1-digit. It's a 3-digit figure. And all are the more than 220, 230, 240. Even last 8 and 9, also the same 3-digit figure.